So let's discuss the differences between an endothermic and an exothermic reaction. Let me draw lines. So the first point under endothermic reaction is, for endothermic reaction, heat is absorbed by the system, and for exothermic reaction, heat is released by the system. Let me put an explanation to this. So let's consider this as my system, and in this the reaction is taking place, and I will draw the surrounding also. So here comes my surrounding. Now for endothermic reaction, heat is absorbed by the system. That means heat is absorbed. This is the direction where the heat flows. So let me write, heat is absorbed for endothermic reaction. For exothermic reaction, so I have drawn an entire setup for the exothermic reaction. Now for exothermic reaction, heat is released by the system. So let me write it down, heat is released by the system. So I hope the first point is clear after looking at that diagram. Now let's move on to the second point. So the second point under endothermic reaction is, temperature of the surrounding is decreased. And for exothermic reaction, the temperature of the surrounding is increased. Let me show this in that same diagram again. So here you can see that for endothermic reaction, heat is absorbed. Now it is very clear that if heat is absorbed by the system, then the temperature of the surrounding will decrease. So the temperature will decrease. The temperature will decrease for the surrounding. And for exothermic, as heat is released from the system to the surrounding, hence the temperature of the surrounding will be increased. So the temperature of the surrounding is increased. So this was the second point. Now let me write down the third point. So the third point says, endothermic reactions are favored by a high temperature surrounding. And for exothermic reactions are favored by a low temperature surrounding. So let's figure out what does this mean. So I have the exact above diagram which I had taken to explain the first point. Now let me represent endothermic reactions in a chemical equation. So let's have A as the reactant. Now for endothermic reactions, this will require some heat. So I will denote this by heat. So A plus heat will give me some product. So this is the reaction. Now what I see here is, heat is required by my system to give the product. So more the heat is absorbed by the system, more favorable is this reaction. So now what I want to say is, if I raise the temperature of the surrounding more than the system, and if I keep on raising the temperature of the surrounding, more better will be the heat transfer from the surrounding to the system. Hence the endothermic reaction will be favored more by a high temperature surrounding. And for the exothermic reaction, I can write the equation something like this. A gives product plus heat, because heat is released for exothermic reactions. Now more the heat released, the better will be the reaction. That means the more heat is released by this equation, the more favorable is the reaction. So if I decrease the surrounding temperature, more better will be this heat transfer. That is, the heat release will be more easier from system to surrounding. So if I decrease the temperature of the surrounding, the exothermic reaction will be more favored. So what I want to say is, exothermic reactions are favored by low temperature surrounding, and endothermic reactions are favored by high temperature surrounding. Let's move on to the fourth point. So the fourth point under endothermic reaction is, the enthalpy of the product is more for endothermic reactions. And for exothermic reactions, the enthalpy of the reactant is more for exothermic reactions. Let me explain this with the help of some diagrams. You can clearly see in this image, you can clearly see that the enthalpy of the product is higher than that of the reactant. The enthalpy is higher than that of the reactant. And for exothermic reactions, we have the enthalpy of the reactant is more. Here the enthalpy of the reactant is more than that of the product. You can see it in this image, that the enthalpy of the reactant is more than that of the product. And for endothermic, we have that the enthalpy of the product is more than that of the reactant. So let's move on to the fifth point, which is easier. For endothermic reactions, the del H is positive. It means that the enthalpy of the reaction is positive for endothermic reactions. And for exothermic reactions, the del H is negative. It means that the enthalpy of the reaction is negative for exothermic reactions. The sixth point will be examples. Dissolution of ammonium chloride in water is an example of an endothermic reaction. And for exothermic reaction, we have, so combustion of methane is an example of an exothermic reaction. You can see methane reacts with 2 moles of oxygen to give carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water, and along with this, heat is released. So this is an example of an exothermic reaction. So these were the differences between endothermic and exothermic reactions. Thank you.